This is an original U.S. three-sheet movie poster from 1956 for Indestructible Man. The poster had been folded and was therefore heavily creased. The owner wanted it flattened out, so we put it on an archival linen backing at Poster Fix. Hi, this is Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix. Today we've got another marvelous and rare vintage poster being restored. Take a look.
That's just a part of a poster. It's about one third. What goes up here? This is what goes up there. This is the top two thirds of the poster. And when you see it, you'll know more about what the poster is. It's the Indestructible Man. Indestructible Man. And they get joined at that line here. This poster is full of creases. But otherwise, it's in great condition, and it's very colorful. I love this poster, and we're going to put it together on a linen backing today at Poster Fix.
I've already prepared this screen. I've stretched canvas on it, and I've laid down acid-free paper onto the canvas with wheat paste, the same substance I'm going to use on this Indestructible Man poster. What I'm going to do is I'm going to apply wheat paste first to the acid-free paper and make sure that it's spread out quite evenly over everywhere. And once I've done it to the acid-free paper, I will then apply the wheat paste to the paper of the poster. And after that's well applied, it will be flipped over so that it can absorb and expand. And then I'll do the other side. While it absorbs the wheat paste, the paper expands because it is porous. Many people have commented about these multi-sheet posters and how they don't line up exactly when they're put together. The reason why they don't line up has nothing to do with absorption of the wheat paste. Nothing. It has everything to do with the fact that before the computer age, which is when these posters were made, plate making was done by hand with rulers, measurements, and then by cameras. And there was always a chance that making one plate would come out a fraction of an inch off from the other plate. More often than not, it did, as well as other phenomena that occur. Because printers of that time could only handle paper up to a certain size. And now, taking a roller, I'm gently pushing out the air pockets that are between the poster and the acid-free paper to make sure that the poster is laying as flat as possible to the linen backing. I have to do it with gentle strokes, working from the center outward, and I have to be careful not to press too hard as to cause any damage from the edge of the roller. So in order for a poster to be big, it had to be made in multi-sheets, and they required separate plates to be made. They were made independently of each other. It's the old analog way of making plates. They're imperfect. That's why they don't align. By the way, I want to say hello to Neil out there and his daughter, Quinn. Hello, Quinn. I hope you're enjoying the show of seeing me linen back Dada's poster. Indestructible Man is a 1956 American crime, horror, science fiction film. An original screenplay by Vi Russell and Sue Dwiggins for producer-director Jack Pollockston, and starring Lon Chaney Jr., Ross Elliott, and Robert Shane. Now this final step has me taking some sponges and gently wiping off the wheat paste residue, which is all over the face of the poster and especially around the edges. It's important that we get the poster completely clean. The picture was produced independently by CGK Productions and distributed in the United States by Allied Artists Pictures Corporation. The film was distributed theatrically in 1956 on a double bill with World Without End, and in some areas with Invasion of the Body Snatchers. Lon Chaney has almost no dialogue in the film. His character's emotions were shown through physical gesture, reminiscent of his iconic father's silent movie persona and extreme close-ups of his face. And I've got the face of it nice and clean now, and I've got to make sure that the edges are also clean. And now it comes time when we have to lay down the next piece. This is the first two-thirds of the poster, and the next piece will be one-third of the poster. Remember, these are plated separately, and because the plates are made separately by hand, the old analog method, they don't line up exactly right. It has nothing to do with wheat paste absorption. It has to do with the way they were printed in the old days. Believe me, I used to work in pre-press plating in the late 80s and early 90s, as I was also doing restoration. And I was learning all about the printing process. Commercial printing as it was before the computer took over, although the transition was beginning in those days and the computer operators were not union, and it was threatening the Lithographers Union of New York. But that's a long story. I'm putting wheat paste again on the poster, and we're going to have this lower sheet expanding before you know it. This movie was told in a narrative noir style, mostly on Los Angeles location, popularized by the television police series Dragnet by police detective Dick Chasen. The story concerns a 72-hour period of horror for the city of Los Angeles. Charles Butcher Benton is a double-crossed, convicted robber and murderer who was executed in the gas chamber. His body is unlawfully sold to a scientist who plans to move his experiments into the cause and cure of cancer to human subjects by rejuvenating damaged human tissue. Benton's corpse is subjected to chemical injection and massive jolts of high voltage electricity in order to study the effect on human tissues. But Benton's heart is re-stimulated and he completely revives, though rendered mute due to electrical damage to his vocal cords. Immensely strong by accelerated growth of cellular mass and with his skin virtually impervious to trauma, scalpels, police bullets, even to bazooka shells. Well, it goes on from there. After killing the doctor and his assistant, Benton sets out in a psychotic rage to avenge himself on his two henchmen and his attorney, Paul Lowe, who, in collusion with the henchmen, had betrayed Benton in order to steal his loot. Benton had left the location map of his stash to his stripper girlfriend, who had since gone straight and begun dating the detective who brought Benton to justice, after she had rejected the lawyer's own advances. Etc., etc., etc. And there we have it. The poster is linen-backed. The pieces are joined together, and we are going to let this thing dry. Well, we're going to let this poster dry for a few days before we commence with the restoration. And I look forward to seeing what this poster is going to look finished. So hang around. You won't want to miss that. If you have any questions about the restoration and linen backing of your posters, get in touch with me at the email address you see on the screen, or you can call me. Tell me something about your posters. Tell me their size, tell me their condition, and send me some photos, and I'd be happy to get back to you with a price for restoration and linen backing. Well, this brings us to the end of another edition of Poster Fix. Remember, my wife and I enjoy bringing your vintage posters back to life and consider it an opportunity to do so. Please keep them coming. We appreciate it. Thank you.